Welcome to this video on exploratory data analysis. Today, we are going to understand this popular and valuable concept with a story. We will cover the concept of exploratory data analysis, that is EDA, where it fits in the business analytics cycle, its importance, and the steps. Anna is a business data analyst and is worried about meeting tight project deadlines. The business stakeholders need insights on why customers are churning and how to prevent that. So, she proposes to her manager Jatin that we skip the exploratory data analysis part and move on to the actual data analysis. She suggests asking the data scientists to share the machine learning algorithm best suited for this business requirement. Jatin listens to all the details but tells her that he disagrees. He tells her that EDA is the foundation stone, a vital step before the data analysis begins. EDA techniques reveal the true nature of the data. It is very similar to an investigation carried out by a detective. Now intrigued, she wanted to know more. He explains that EDA is digging deep into piles of data to find clues that will aid the actual data analysis, like a detective. The better you know your data, that is, have more clues, the better is your analysis, that is, the case outcome. He also tells her that learning what you can do using the data available will make your final analysis more robust and effective. Open-minded exploration of data will provide valuable information. It is all about finding and revealing clues. Anna is excited and wants to know more. She is wondering about the different ways in which EDA can help. So Jatin explains that the first objective of EDA is to confirm if the collected data makes sense in the context of the business problem that we are trying to solve. If not, we need to collect more data or change the strategy. Imagine the time and amount spent if EDA was not done, and you realize that the data is not suitable for the analysis halfway through. Now, you would be very lucky if the data you get or collect is clean. This is hardly ever the case. EDA is helpful to uncover and resolve data quality issues like missing data, duplicates, incorrect values, that is anomalies, incorrect data types, and the list is very long. The EDA reveals the data summaries like the descriptive statistics like mean, median, standard deviation, etc. All these are very important to know before we draw any conclusions from the data. Many times, some values may lie far away from the standard set of values. These are called anomalies, and they need to be verified before they go into data analysis. If unchecked, they will create havoc in the analysis, misconstrue calculations. Using EDA, we may uncover the behavior of variables when clubbed together. Their correlation tells us how much and in which direction we should expect one variable to change when the other changes. It is a value between negative 1 to positive 1, indicating a strong negative or strong positive relationship. Correlation plays a vital role in locating the crucial variables on which other variables depend. Not all columns from the data we have collected are helpful for our analysis. Also, we may often need to create new columns from the columns we have using business knowledge. EDA can play an important role in this process. Anna agrees that EDA is a vital step before the analysis and will save a lot of time and effort if done correctly. Jatin explains that EDA is done once we have defined our business problem or opportunity and have our data ready. So, before the analysis, we know whether the data is appropriate and take corrective action if required, or what the data looks like, how it can be prepared for the analysis, and so on. Now, Jatin and Anna decide to work on the EDA for the data that their team has collected. So they start with univariate analysis that looks at single variables like age, salary, and so on. For the categorical variable like area code, a simple tabulation of the frequency of each category is helpful. They find that area code 415 has the highest number of customers. For numerical variables, they use descriptive statistics summary to get details like mean, mode, standard deviation. As a starter, this tells them that there are some missing values which need to be resolved before the analysis. Next, they move on to visualizing univariate variables. Categorical data can be easily represented by a bar chart. This chart tells us that West Virginia has the highest total day calls, a strong customer base. For quantitative data, histograms, which are bar plots in which each bar represents the frequency or count of the cases for a range of values, are very useful. They help in understanding the central tendency, spread, shape, and outliers. This histogram reveals that customers with account lengths between 90 and 180 have a higher tendency to churn. Maybe some offers or loyalty points can be introduced. Now, Anna is happy that they are getting so much information already. They move on to multivariate non-graphical analysis, where two or more variables are analyzed together. Cross-tabulated reports of two or more variables fall into this category. A simple report tells us that customers who don't have an international plan are more likely to churn. In case of graphical analysis, scatter plots, which help visualize two quantitative variables, have one variable on the x-axis and another on the y-axis. They saw a pattern that customers with low day minutes and high service calls have high churn rates. So, EDA is generally cross-classified. It can be done non-graphically or graphically and is further divided into either univariate or multivariate. Further analysis revealed many insights which proved the importance of EDA before the actual analysis. Convinced and happy to have such a supportive mentor manager. Thank you for joining us today, and I hope the EDA concept is clearly understood. And yeah, check out more about the exploratory data analysis using Excel course to get started with your analytics journey. Wish you all the best, and thank you.